Well, with our drought in its third week, many of us are struggling to keep gardens growing. In this edition of Sunday Gardening, Sally Severson has a host of plants that need little water.
Carrie, you're thinking outside of the box again. We've got a bird bath, but you're going to plant it.
I love to make container gardening fun. So, like I said, gardening's the number one hobby in America. There's no reason why we have to stop in May. This is something you can do any time of the year.
Okay.
So we're going to do succulents. We have these great bird baths in all these fun colors.
I love this, yeah. This kind of turquoisey blue. And you've got different
turquoise.
Sizes.
Different size. You can do a little mini version if you want.
Mm-hmm.
This is a nice deep one, so it lends well to be able to use for multiple purposes.
Okay.
I'm using a special soil. As you can see, it looks much different. It's much lighter.
Yeah.
And it has a lot of perlite in it, so it's nice and light, good drainage, sand.
For these particular plants, for the succulents.
Yes, we're talking succulents.
So alrighty, I'll take that.
Cactuses, succulents, you can mix and match as you like.
Okay.
And the keys to succulents is the color, texture, size, and shape. So I pulled a lot of variety here.
Right.
And they're really fun. This is fun for any age to come through and pick out different options. So something that's fun and unique, this is called flapjack.
Yeah.
And you just, I like to set them into place.
And kind of look at it a little bit?
Story going.
Okay.
So you can join me and jump in, and there's no right or wrong. It's just,
well, you're the creative one here.
So this is, they're fun to touch. So you can play with them and
love the color on this.
Yeah, isn't that neat?
Yeah.
This one's kind of fuzzy and furry. And
mm-hmm.
So it's a great thing for children to get exposed to the fun gardening. And this is a perennial type, as they call this cobweb.
Yeah.
So,
and you're great about packing them in, too.
You know, I am. I love it. So, but this looks, we're doing about right.
Okay.
The only thing, maybe these two.
Too close together with the color.
Yeah, so take one out, put one in its place, and there we go. So you can plant them in here. I like to finish it off with these nice river stones.
Okay.
Yeah, you can do that. And sometimes people just bring their container right in here and plant it right on site. Because you get home and you're like, oh no, I wish I had that one.
Right. So, and you know that you're leaving with everything you need and want.
Yes. So you, like I said, there's some here that it's just one plant. That's fine too. A little bit of trim. You can make this any way that you want. And this is, I did a bird bath at my own home and brought it inside for the winter and had it in a nice bright window. It was such an amazing statement piece.
I'll bet. And especially with the little river stones. Now, caring for these, you've got the special soil.
Right. You've got the soil that to help with that drainage. I mean, obviously, there's no drainage hole here, so you want to be gentle and make sure you're not going to be watering too much.
Or the table it's on.
Yeah, exactly. Uh-huh. So you want to make sure you have good drainage. Fertilizer helps with a nice, beautiful foliage. You can do that once a week, helps the plants grow. Some of them will get some flowers coming up,
mm-hmm.
and if you enjoy them, you can leave them on, you can take them off, however you want this image to be. It's really your creativity.
And it's just absolutely gorgeous. Thank you, Kara.
Sure.
And our thanks to Sally. Remember, you can find all the recent Sunday Gardener segments on our website, wisn.com. You just look under the Marketplace tab.